Hello students, welcome to Target IES. I hope you are having a wonderful day. Let us continue with the very first module of Strength of Materials. Before I start the Strength of Materials, let me make it one thing very clear. If you see GATE syllabus, there will be clear cut mechanics part. ठीक है? Mechanics part आपको clear cut syllabus में मिल जाएगा. If you are seeing any state PSC exam syllabus, obviously this mechanic part will be there followed by Strength of Materials part. ठीक है, बट इफ यू आर सीइंग जस्ट ईएससी सिलेबस, वहां पे आपको प्योर सॉलिड मैकेनिक्स मिल जाएगा. देर वोंट बी एनी मैकेनिक्स पार्ट इंक्लूडेड. बट इफ यू आर सीइंग प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन पेपर्स, देर विल बी लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस व्हिच यू कैन सॉल्व यूजिंग सिंपल मैकेनिक्स नॉलेज. ओके, देयरफॉर मैकेनिक्स इज क्वाइट इंपॉर्टेंट. इवन दो यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर ईएससी, मैकेनिक्स इंपॉर्टेंट है. So what you have to do is you have to watch these videos and it will definitely help you in solving questions related to not only strength of materials, but if some concepts come in different subjects also, you will be able to apply these concepts and score some marks if you are perfect in mechanics part. Okay, so far clear, right? Why you have to study mechanics? First state PSC, this is very important part. Yaad rakhlo, state PSCs ke liye kafi important hai. So in this revision series, whatever I am going to teach you, so I will make sure that everything is covered. Okay, so if you are seeing this notes, whatever I have provided to you, a short notes jo bhi maine aapko provide kiya hai, so not only the regular topics but also in some state PSCs. Okay, so this is the end of GATE syllabus, but after GATE syllabus also I have given some extra topics for state PSCs. If you are writing any state PSC, especially from southern states, there are some extra concepts, whether you are for Telangana, Andhra Pradesh. So these states, they ask for some concepts little bit more, which are not present in your typical civil engineering syllabus, like lifting machines ho gaya. So all this part I have added here, or pulleys ho gaya, so that it will be an advantage for you. So just follow this, you will be good enough to score out and out in your examination. So let us start with something very simple, which you already are aware of. Okay, so there are some basic concepts of mechanics. When I am talking about mechanics, you are learning this mechanics from your school itself, right? School mein hi padha tha mechanics sara, agreed or not? So you know what are the basic formulas of mechanics? V is equals to U plus AT, S is equals to UT plus of AT square, V square is equals to U square plus 2AS. Whatever there are, this simple formulae you are already aware of. But what we will do is, we will read them again and we will also see resultant of forces in this module. ठीक है, a resultant of forces काफी important है. You can expect a question definitely to come in all your state PSC exams. Not only that, gate में भी पूछने के पूरे पूरे chances है. और you can also expect a 2 marks question to come in your ESC examination. ऐसा बिल्कुल नहीं है कि वो syllabus को stick करेंगे, because this is basic part. A question can appear in your ESC also. So let us start with very basic formulae of mechanics. When a body is displacing from one point to the other point, we can define the rate at which this displacement is taking place as velocity. So what is velocity? It is nothing but rate of change of displacement. ds by dt kar loge to aapko velocity aa jayega. Done? Clear? नेक्स्ट आके एक्सीलरेशन है. व्हाट इज दिस एक्सीलरेशन? सो व्हेन अ बॉडी इज मूविंग फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट वन टू पॉइंट टू, ये जो डिस्टेंस कवर कर रहा है यूजिंग सर्टेन वेलोसिटी, देयर इज सर्टेन पार्ट विथ विच इट इज एक्सीलरेटिंग. सो एक्सीलरेशन इज नथिंग बट रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ वेलोसिटी विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू टाइम. ओके, सो हाउ यू कैन राइट इट एज दिस वी इज नथिंग बट ds by dt. So you are writing it as dou square s by dt square. Okay, clear? See, the velocity and acceleration, whatever we are discussing here, are linear velocity and linear acceleration. But what if the body is moving in a curved path? Let us say from point 1 to point 2 it is moving. Okay? Then obviously we can introduce new terms like angular velocity and angular acceleration, very similar to that of linear velocity and linear acceleration. You might be remembering these formulas, right? V is equals to omega r, right? Where omega is your angular velocity, or you can write your angular velocity as v by r. Kara hoga aapne, in your high school, right? Or there is one more formula for your angular velocity, which is 2 pi n by 60. And what are the units? Units काफी simple है. For your linear velocity, it was meter per second. Angular velocity हम radians में measure करते हैं, radians divided by second. So how to define this omega? First of all, how can you define in simple language? अरे कुछ भी नहीं है यार. So whenever you are talking about linear velocity, it was rate of change of its position, right? So ds by dt tha in simple language. But here what is changing? Whenever you are traveling in a circular path, its angular position is changing, agreed or not? Its angular position is changing with respect to time. Therefore, I can write this angular velocity as nothing but d theta by dt, rate of change of angular position. So how to define this omega? Rate of change of angular position, of angular position. You can write a note so that you will be remembering for lot of time. Concept to samajh mein aa gaya na? Similarly, what will be your angular acceleration? That will be nothing but your linear acceleration divided by your radius vector. Divided by your radius. And what will be the units? Units yaad rakh lo, it is moving in a circle, so radians aa jayega. Radians divided by second square. Okay, so omega ke units kya hai? It is radians divided by second, and your alpha, radians divided by second square. Done, yaad rakhoge. So this is about your linear acceleration and linear velocity as well as angular velocity and angular acceleration. Units yaad rakh lo and everything you remember. And what is the centripetal acceleration? See, whenever you are rotating a body, for example, thread le lo. At the end of a thread, just tie a stone and revolve it with a higher velocity. Just revolve it. So whenever you are revolving it, you can try to understand what is happening. So here there is a string attached, right? So the string is exerting certain force on the stone, agreed or not? So this I am calling it as centripetal force. ठीक है? So what is happening? यहाँ पे एक resultant force आ रहा है from your hand, and there is a force acting at the stone, right, which is making it to revolve in a circular motion. We are calling it as centripetal force. A common sense ki baat hai, when there is a force acting like this, obviously body kya ho jayega? It will be coming towards your hand. But what is happening? Till you are rotating, it will be revolving in a circular motion only. This is possible because there will be a force acting here, which we are calling it as centrifugal force. A force which is acting away from my body is called as centrifugal force. Now coming to this centripetal force acceleration, my centripetal acceleration, which I can denote by AC, it is very similar to that of V square by R, or you can write it as omega square R. Simple, eh? There is nothing much here, right? These all concepts you know already. And I hope, even if you know, this is helping you as a revision, right? This is like recollecting you the things which you might have forgotten, and small questions can come. And read these notes and whatever formula I have given in detail. And coming to the formulas of kinematics, you already know these formulas. V is equals to u plus at, s is equals to ut plus half at square, v square is equals to u square plus 2as. See, these formulas you already know. But the questions which will be coming will be little bit different. You have to use your common sense. Remember, whenever you are using this acceleration, it is average acceleration. Okay, so let us write a question. How a question will come, let us see how many people can solve. If a simple question comes, this is the question which repeated many times. The acceleration of a particle starting from rest. Okay, please write down acceleration of particle starting from rest. Just give me a second. Write it down in your notes. Decreases uniformly from 10 meter per second square at t is equals to 0 to 0 at t is equals to 11 seconds. The maximum velocity of particle is, the maximum velocity of particle is. So you can use this formula v is equals to u plus at, राइट तो कहां पे यूज करोगे, इट इज स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम रेस्ट, सो वी यू क्या हो जाएगा, यू जीरो हो जाएगा, राइट सो यू विल बी राइटिंग 0 + a × t, क्या लिख दोगे, योर टी मैक्सिमम इज 10 m/s², सो यू विल बी राइटिंग 10 × टाइम इज अगेन 11 सेकेंड्स, सो 10 × 11 यू विल बी राइटिंग एज 110 m/s, देयर विल बी फोर ऑप्शंस, 110, 55, 550 एंड 660. As soon as you take your answer as 110, you will be losing your marks. Common sense use करना है. You should be writing your average acceleration, not your maximum acceleration. Obviously, because it is retarding with respect to time. So what you will be writing? You will be writing u plus a average into t. So u is 0 plus a average कितना हो जाएगा? What will be your average acceleration? That will be 0 plus 10 divided by 2 into time taken is 11 seconds. So 5 into 11, 55 seconds, 55 m/s is your answer. ठीक है? So what is the maximum velocity you can obtain from this body? That is obviously 110, 55, 550, 660. Answer is 55 m/s. So like this, you should be applying your brain carefully. Okay? सो ब्लाइंडली सब्स्टिट्यूट मत कर लो, कॉमन सेंस की बात है, यूज योर कॉमन सेंस एंड सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चंस. एंड इफ अ बॉडी इज ट्रेवलिंग इन लेट अस से फॉर एन सेकेंड्स, व्हाट विल बी द डिस्टेंस इट इज कवर्ड इन द एंथ सेकेंड. फॉर्मूला क्या है, एस एन इक्वल्स टू यू प्लस ए बाई टू इंटू 2n-1. लेट मी रिमाइंड यू व्हाई आई हैव गिवन दिस फॉर्मूला. मुझे सिविल इंजीनियरिंग में नहीं पूछा गया है क्वेश्चन. When I was preparing in one of the examination, there was logic and reasoning part, no? In that logic and reasoning, what was the distance it traveled in n second was a question. That's why I'm giving here. So whatever formula I'm giving, no, it will be helpful to you in some or some form. So don't take it easy, and whatever formulas I have given, practice it once or twice so that you will be perfect and you will be using it in your examinations as per requirement. Similar to linear velocity formulas, you can also write it in terms of angular velocity formulas. So please make sure you remember these formulas also. Omega is equals to omega naught plus alpha t, theta, which is your angle, right? So theta is equals to omega naught t plus of alpha t square, and your omega square is equals to omega naught square plus 2 alpha theta. I hope you'll be remembering it right. Next is simple harmonic motion. I am skipping this part because it is very simple. And you know what is your periodic time, the time required for one complete revolution, I am calling it as periodic time, and it is given by 2 pi by omega seconds. Okay, the time required for a body to revolve around, I am considering it as 2 pi by omega seconds, right? And what will be the frequency? Frequency is nothing but 1 by your time period. Okay, so it will be omega by 2 pi, and what will be the units of frequency? Hertz. So no need to remember, this is I have given the complete formulas which you will be using, but इसका कोई गारंटी नहीं कि ये फॉर्मूला से क्वेश्चन आएंगे. ठीक है? सो वॉट एवर आई एम टीचिंग आर इम्पॉर्टेंट, जस्ट प्रैक्टिस इट वंस ट्वाइस एंड इट विल बी मोर देन एनफ, बिकॉज दिस इज मोर लाइक अ रिविजन फॉर यू. सो इफ यू आर टेकिंग अ सिंपल पेंडुलम, बिकॉज आई एम टीचिंग सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन, मैंडेटरी है एक सिंपल पेंडुलम, एक कॉम्पाउंड पेंडुलम ले लूँ और उसके फॉर्मूलाज दे दूँ. इफ यू हैव अ सिंपल पेंडुलम, देन द टाइम पीरियड जनरली वॉचेस में हम दिखाते हैं ना, छोटे जब प्रॉब्लम्स आते थे इसमें स्कूल से, सो द टाइम पीरियड विल बी 2 π√L/g. इफ यू आर टेकिंग कॉम्पाउंड पेंडुलम, देन 2 π√2k/g. नेक्स्ट इज सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स. आई हैव एक्सप्लेन व्हाट इज सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स, राइट? टू कीप अ बॉडी रिवॉल्विंग इन अ सर्कुलर मोशन, बिकॉज देर इज अ सेंट्रीपिटल फोर्स एक्टिंग, देर शुड बी सम फोर्स विच शुड बी एक्टिंग एंड मूविंग माई बॉडी अवे फ्रॉम सर्कल, सो दैट अ सर्कुलर मोशन इज पॉसिबल. इट विल रिमेन इन सर्कल इंस्टेड ऑफ गोइंग एंड हिटिंग यूर हैंड. आई होप यू आर गेटिंग इट राइट. सो दिस फोर्स आई एम कॉलिंग इट एज सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स, एंड द फॉर्मूला फॉर दिस सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स विल बी एम ओमेगा स्क्वायर आर. रिमेंबर द फॉर्मूला, इंपॉर्टेंट है. नेक्स्ट आके थ्री इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म्स विच विल बी यूजिंग वेरी फ्रीक्वेंटली, वर्क, पावर एंड एनर्जी. ओके, वर्क. सी इन सिंपल लैंग्वेज, इन यूअर सिविल इंजीनियरिंग और मैकेनिकल टर्म्स, रिमेंबर वर्क यू कैन डिफाइन इट एज फोर्स इंटू डिस्टेंस. फोर्स इनटू डिस्टेंस हम एक और चीज के लिए यूज करते हैं, विच इज नथिंग बट मोमेंट, राइट राइट फॉर मोमेंट टू बी प्रिसाइज इट इज फोर्स इनटू परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस, वेर एज इन वर्क इट इज जस्ट फोर्स इनटू डिस्टेंस. आई होप इट इज वेरी क्लियर, राइट. So next is power. The rate of doing this work, whatever work you are doing, I am calling it as power. So it is nothing but work divided by time. So my work was force into distance. Where will be my power? Will be force into distance divided by time. See, this distance divided by time, what is it? What is it, beta? Displacement divided by time हम कैसे लिख सकते हैं? I can write it as velocity, right? So my power is F into V. Give it 5-star, very important formula है. My power is force into velocity. This is the formula which we'll be using frequently in fluid mechanics also. So remember this power, how I am writing it? I am writing it as force into velocity and we'll be using it very frequently. If you are talking about angular velocity, it will be T into omega. Torque into omega. So my power is also written as 2 pi n, which is omega, right? 2 pi n by 60 kya hai? Omega. What is the formula? Omega t, right? So 2 pi n t by 60. Okay, so these formulas you should remember whenever you are solving some question. What is the power required? If you are seeing these terms n t hai, just formula mein substitute kar lo, aapko aapka power mil jayega. Next is energy. What is this energy? Energy is nothing but your capacity of a certain body to do the work. Okay, so capacity of work done is called as energy. Whether you have a capacity to do a certain work, I am classifying it as energy. This energy, predominantly we can classify it as potential energy and kinetic energy, right? If a body is falling with respect to the position, then we will be calling it as potential energy. So that will be nothing but if a body has a weight W and it is falling from a height H, then my potential energy is WH. Or you can write it as W weight is equals to mass into gravitational force. So you can write it as MGH. Right. Next is kinetic energy. It is due to your velocity, right? Velocity of motion. So the formula for your kinetic energy is of mv square. Yahan tak to theek hai, but the question can come, what is the kinetic energy of rotation? See, whenever you have measuring kinetic energy because of the rotation, the formula will be of I omega square, where I is your moment of inertia. Where I is your moment of inertia. If a body is undergoing both linear and rotational motion, then the energy, whatever is it, is of mv square because of linear part, and because of rotation part, of I omega square. Of I omega square. Yaad rakhoge? Clear hai? See, you might be knowing most of the formula, but problem comes in execution of that formula. Moment, you all know force into perpendicular distance is your moment. But question kaisa aayega? Question kaisa aayega? Question kuch is tarah aayega. There is a force traveling. Let us say the force de dega 3i plus 4j plus k. 3i plus 4j plus k passing through the point I minus j. What is the moment? What is the moment? You know the formula, force into distance. Question आ गया कुछ इस तरह से, क्या करोगे आप? Very important question है, बहुत बार आ चुका है. So I am giving this. Your moment is your force into distance. If vector दिया तो हम वैसे ही multiply कर लेंगे. So what will be it? I, J, K. Your force is 3, 4, 1. And here it is 1, minus 1, 0. So this is your answer. So I into cross multiply कर लो, what you are getting? You are getting plus 1 minus j into, you know this right? Plus minus plus. So यहाँ पे minus आया, plus minus j into. Now what you have to take? You have to ignore it and cross multiply and cross multiply. So 3 into 0 minus 1 into 1. So that. And plus k into, ignore this k part. You know how to cross multiply, right? You are gems, I know that. So minus 3 minus 4. So you are getting I plus J minus 7K. This will be your moment. This will be your moment. I plus J minus 7K is your moment. Like that you have to apply your concepts. Done. Yahan tak to ho gaya. Iske baad hum resultant of forces mein chale jayenge. Before that, Let us try to understand four terms which you should be aware of. First one is concurrent. Second one is coplanar. Next is coplanar concurrent. Okay. And next is coplanar non-concurrent. Okay. So these are the four things which you should be aware of. First one is concurrent. If the forces are meeting at a point, then I will be calling them as concurrent forces. What is coplanar? See, if all the forces are acting along the same plane, then we'll be calling it as coplanar. Okay. For example, let us try to understand. Ek three-dimensional body le lenge. So that you can easily understand. That's the only reason why I am taking this. Okay, so just see this surface. Front face ka jo bhi surface hai, wahi hum dekh rahe hain. Theek hai? This front face wala surface, this is the surface. So if the forces are acting on this surface, all the forces are acting on this surface, theek hai? Then I will be calling all these forces as what? Coplanar forces, because they are acting on a same plane. Okay, I hope it is very clear for you. So if the forces are acting on a same plane, then coplanar. But if you have force system something like this, okay, so better I show with the help of some three-dimensional body, it will be easy for you to understand. So on the top surface, ye jo surface hai, let me write it with the red ink. So on this surface, the forces are like this. There are forces. These two forces are coplanar, right? Because they are on same plane. Agreed or not? So if there is one more force on this plane acting, ye jo face hai, iske upar act kar raha hai. Theek hai? So are these forces coplanar? No, they are not coplanar. Okay, they are non-coplanar forces. Okay, even if the forces are acting like this, it doesn't matter. But at a point, if they are meeting, it could be coming from any plane. But if they are meeting at a point, I will be calling them as concurrent. Okay, so what is coplanar concurrent? All the forces are in the same plane, and if they are meeting at a point, then I will be calling it as coplanar concurrent. Coplanar non-concurrent, all the forces are on same plane, but they are not meeting. Something like this. Okay? They are not meeting at a common point. Then we will be calling it as coplanar non-concurrent forces. Done. Ita to common sense hai aapko. Now you understand. Even if you know this but you have forgotten, I hope after this you remember all these concepts, right? Simple se concepts then. See, for a body to be in an equilibrium, this is a very, 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 very important note. If there are three non-parallel forces to be in an equilibrium, they should be concurrent and need not be coplanar. See, to be in an equilibrium, you know what is equilibrium? No, there is no relative motion. It is staying at that point. So, to be in an equilibrium, the forces need not be coplanar. Okay? Coplanar nahi hai to bhi chalega. But they should be concurrent. For example, tripod le lo. Tripod is something like this. Right? So, you can see, if I am representing this by some forces, these forces are on different planes. Agreed or not? But they are meeting at a point. So, remember, the main thing for a equilibrium is concurrency. Okay, for three non-parallel forces to be in equilibrium, they should be concurrent. They need not be coplanar. Okay, so even if they are planar, it's good. Equilibrium ho jayega. For example, if there is a force acting on a body and if there is one more force acting, obviously kya ho raha hai? Body is in equilibrium. Agreed or not? This is coplanar also. But coplanar is not mandatory. If you are seeing a tripod, something like this, it is standing at a position only, right? Agreed or not? Why it is standing? Coplanar ke forces? No, not coplanar. Why they are standing? Concurrency is a very important role here. Okay? So, concurrent hai. To coplanar nahi hai, to bhi equilibrium mein rehne ke chances hai. Done? So, next is parallelogram law. See, I have directly written the formula because I hope you remember this these concepts. If not, please make a note. Parallelogram law. How many of you remember this? Comment down in the comment section if you remember this law. काफी simple सा law है. I hope every student remembers of target AES. Even if you don't, no issues. Now you will be recollecting this concept. It states when two forces are acting simultaneously on a particle. Let us say there are two forces Q and P. They are acting simultaneously on a particle and represented in magnitude and direction by two adjacent sides of parallelogram. Okay, these forces are acting how? As if two adjacent sides of parallelogram. Then how you can write the resultant? The resultant you can represent in magnitude and direction by the resultant of these two forces, right? I hope you remember it, right? If two forces are acting simultaneously on a particle and they are represented in magnitude and direction along the two sides of parallelogram, then the resultant kya ho jayega? Resultant is represented in magnitude and direction along, for example, this is the parallelogram which you are making. Then diagonal dallo, this diagonal will represent what? This will represent your resultant force of these two forces P and Q. काफी सिंपल है, याद रखोगे आप. सी नाउ कम्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट. ये जो फॉर्मूला है रिजल्टेंट का, हाउ मच इज इट? सी रिमेंबर दिस डायग्राम ऑलवेज. ओके, सो व्हेन देयर आर टू फोर्सेस Q एंड P, द रिजल्टेंट विल बी अंडर रूट पी स्क्वायर प्लस क्यू स्क्वायर प्लस टू पी क्यू कॉस अल्फा. कॉस अल्फा, दिस एंगल इज अल्फा. ओके, सो वॉट विल बी दिस थीटा? रिजल्टेंट फोर्स एंगल विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू पी, वॉट इज इट? tan theta is equals to q sin alpha divided by p plus q cos alpha. Very important formulas you have to remember by heart karna hai aapko. So r is equals to under root p square plus q square plus 2pq cos alpha, and your tan theta, which is the angle the resultant is making with p, that theta is equals to q sin alpha by p plus q cos alpha. See, one of the important thing what you have to do is understanding concepts by heart nahi karna hai. See, what I did was I remember this formula as it is, and I went in exam, ek chota sa state PSC exam tha. He said there are two forces acting P, Q, and here I have my resultant force. What is this theta? What is this theta? So I ticked, as soon as I tick, I know the formula, mujhe yaad tha, my resultant force, this tan theta, whatever it is making, it is q sin alpha, if this is alpha, divided by p plus q cos alpha. जैसे ही मैं देखा मैंने उसे टिक मार दिया. ठीक है, जैसे ही मैंने देखा मैंने उसे टिक मार दिया, एंड आई लॉस्ट माई मार्क्स. वाई? वॉट इज द डिफरेंस? सी लेट अस बी वेरी क्लियर. वॉट आई हैव थॉट यू इज q इज अप, p इज बिलो एंड r इज हियर. ठीक है, सो लेट्स नॉट इंटरचेंज इट. ओके, यूज दिस सिंपल टैक्टिक्स. ओके, यहाँ पे मार्क्स लूज कर सकते हैं, सो ब्लाइंडली फॉर्मूला बाय हार्ट मत करो, रिमेंबर इट. ओके, इफ दिस इज द बेस वन, दिस इज द बेस वन, देन ओनली यू कैन अप्लाई दिस फॉर्मूला. इफ देर इज सम फोर्सेस लाइक दिस, इफ देर इज टू फोर्सेस हियर P, हियर Q एंड हियर यूर R, देन यूर tan theta is equals to whatever upper part is there, P sin alpha divided by Q, whatever bottom part is there, plus P cos alpha. Be careful here, because I have lost mark, because of my stupidity which I have learned directly from my textbooks, and seedha exam mein jaake maine likh diya, sirf term upar niche kar diya, I have lost marks. I don't want you to repeat this. Okay, so whenever you are seeing that, please make sure. And what is your resultant force? R is equals to under root P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos alpha. Cos alpha, right? This is alpha, the angle between two forces, right? So I hope you will be remembering it. Kafi simple hai. Now comes the important part. What if your P and Q are same? What is your P and Q are same? What will be your resultant force? See, don't waste time in calculating under root P square plus P square plus 2p into p cos alpha like that. Directly you can remember your resultant force will be 2p cos alpha by 2. This is a very frequently asked bit, that's why I'm giving you the reason directly. If p is equals to q, then your resultant R is equals to 2p cos alpha by 2. Or you can also solve p square plus p square plus 2pq, which is again 2p square cos alpha. So you can solve it also. You can get the answer, but solve karne mein sar dard ho jayega because it is too much trigonometry involved. So you can directly remember it is 2p cos alpha by 2. ये काफी सिंपल रहेगा, याद रख लो डायरेक्टली. एंड नेक्स्ट व्हाट यू आर गेटिंग एंड व्हाट विल बी द थीटा, इफ दे आर टू फोर्सेस व्हाट विल बी द थीटा, इफ दे आर इक्वल देन थीटा विल बी एट 45 डिग्रीज, इफ दे आर एट 90 डिग्रीज 45 डिग्रीज एग्जैक्टली, इफ दे आर मेकिंग सम अल्फा देन दैट विल बी अल्फा बाय 2, इफ इट इज एट द एंगल ऑफ 60 देन योर थीटा विल बी 30 डिग्रीज. आई होप इट इज वेरी क्लियर, राइट? सो फॉर अ बॉडी टू बी इन इक्विलिब्रियम, व्हेन अ बॉडी विल बी इन इक्विलिब्रियम, लेट अस से देयर इज अ बॉडी. For that to be in equilibrium, the forces, the resultant force, whatever you are getting, it should be zero, right? The resultant force should be zero. सिर्फ एक ही काफ़ी नहीं है, सिर्फ एक ही काफ़ी नहीं है. Resultant force zero होने के बावजूद the body might not be in equilibrium. There are two conditions. First one is resultant force should be equal to zero. Next one is momentum of a force at a point should be equals to zero. Okay, so second one is also very important. Momentum of a force at any point is equal to zero. Why I am saying this? Let us be very careful. There is a body and यहाँ पे एक force है. Let us say this force is 10 kN and this force is 10 kN. But they are acting at different points, point A and point B. यहाँ पे क्या हो रहा है? What is the resultant force? Resultant force is 10 minus 10, which is zero. Resultant force is zero. So you can you say this is under equilibrium? No, this is not under equilibrium. See carefully, there is a force acting here, there is a force acting here. The body will be revolved, right? Just imagine a pen, take a pen, yahan pe ek force apply karo, yahan pe ek force apply karo. This body will be rotating, agreed or not? If the body is rotating, can you consider it as equilibrium? No, you cannot consider. That's why you have to check moment also. If there is no moment and resultant force is also zero, then I can say the body is in equilibrium. I hope concept is clear, right? I hope concept is clear. And now let us see this, how to change a force from one position to other position. Let us see this. I want to transfer this force F, which is at point A, to point B. How can you transfer? Very simple. What you can do, I want to transfer it to B, right? So what I am doing, there is a force F. I am adding a force at B and in a upward direction, and I'm also adding a force in downward direction, so that what is the net force here? At B the net force is zero, and at A your net force is F upwards. Agreed or not? Agreed or not? When two forces, equal and opposite forces, are acting at certain distance, if this is F, this is minus F, so it forms a couple. A body kya ho raha hai? You can see at the center the body is trying to rotate. It is similar to that of a force is acting upwards downwards. So this body will rotate, right? So I am calling that moment being generated because of this opposite nature forces, I am calling it as couple. ठीक है? So what I am doing, you can clearly see here at A there was F force. At B, I want to transfer this force to point B. So what I have done, I have added F in upward direction, in downward direction, right? So that here the resultant force is zero. Agreed or not? So now see this force F and this force F. Okay, it is like a couple, right? On this plane, there is a force acting like this, there is a force acting like this, and there is a certain distance. Agreed or not? So it is like a couple. Force into distance, right? Force into distance, that will be the moment. So here what I am doing is, let us be very careful, I am just writing it as A. At B there is a force and I am writing a couple instead. Okay, so now what I have done, I have transferred a force from A to B by applying certain moment, and my result will be the same as that of whatever force I have applied in this diagram 1. Concept is clear? Samajhne aa gaya concept? Yaad rakhoge, right? This is how you can shift a force from one point to other point by adding couple. Okay, I am taking this class from half an hour, so what I will do is I will stop this class here and I will continue these concepts of Lamy's theorem, Verignon's principle, all this in the next class. Okay, I will cover this in the next class. Till radius of gyration, okay, till this part, till this moment of inertia, sorry, what happened to this, till this moment of inertia I will complete in the next module, and after that in the third module I will teach you moment of inertia concepts. All these are very important. Center of gravity, very important for your state PSCs and gate examination. And in the next module we will see friction and this pulley system. I think 4 modules are good enough, and even in the worst case 5 modules. So we'll be finishing the entire mechanics, and this mechanics is more than enough for any civil engineering student who is appearing any competitive exams. There is no need of even doing a regular big course. Watch this. After that, what you do, just watch this, whatever I'm teaching you, notes ke formulas do teen baar by heart kar lo, solve the previous year question papers of gate or any state PSCs. You will be good enough to score out and out if you are doing that. Okay, this crash course wala course kafi hai mechanics ke liye, because it is a very simple subject. I hope it is very clear. See you in the next module, in which I am going to continue these concepts of equilibrium, and I will also teach you kinetics also. Okay, have a nice day. See you in next module.